It looked like a lot of those three-pointers were open shots. Is that from what you saw from your vantage point?
Yeah, we just didn't make them. We generated a lot of them. You look at, you know, Timmy 0 for 7, Luka 2 for 9, Kai 1 for 5. You know, they're wide open looks. Just didn't drop for us this afternoon or this evening.
Was it those missed threes that also led to a lot of their fast breaks?
Yeah, they made a point to have pace. They took advantage of the misses, and they, you know, got to the rim. You look at what Russell did tonight. You know, he had 29 points. He was going, and so they played off of him and AD tonight, and that just put a lot of pressure on our defense, and then it put more pressure on our offense when we were playing from behind and missing. You know, when you miss open shots against a team like that, they're going to make you pay for it.
How do you slow down AD when he gets it going like that?
You can't. He's playing at a very high level. We said that before the game. They're playing to him. He's getting to the basket, to the free throw line. You got to try to double team him, and then he's relying on playing on the perimeter to beat the double team. So you just got to try to make it hard as possible and hope he misses at the right time. But tonight he played well.
Kyrie experiencing any discomfort when LeBron crashed into him there?
Yeah, I think he hurt his hip there, and he was just trying to, you know, get loose and try to, you know, get back into the flow and things. And I think he just struggled, you know, from that point on.
After Luka missing a few games, I guess big best bright spot for tonight was him coming back and playing well.
Yeah, anytime Luka comes back, it's a positive. Just the rhythm of the team to get back. You know, guys were playing different roles. Luka comes back, got to make the adjustment, and it takes a little time. Hopefully, if the game is played on Friday, that we can get back into that rhythm. But if not, we go home and we'll have a practice here for the first time in a long time, and hopefully we can gain that rhythm.
Jason, how do you comprehend LeBron making the kind of plays he did tonight in his 21st season?
Yeah, it's LeBron. This is something, you know, if you were a betting man, you would bet with him against Father Time. You know, just the things that he's done, you know, to date, just doesn't look like he gets tired. He understands the game at a high level. He's shooting a three very well, and he just lets the game come to him. It just, you know, shows, you know, to our youth that, you know, if you understand the game, you can play for a long time. And hopefully the youth is watching.
You went to Maxi over Lively early in the third quarter. What was the thinking on just that decision?
Yeah, well, Lively was struggling a little bit. And then also we want to make sure we got Maxi's minutes in. If we're not going to have practice, we got to figure out we're juggling practice during the game and getting guys you know, knocking off the rust. So this is a little complex where you're trying to get guys going and play a game and try to win a game. But we felt at that point DeLive was struggling a little bit to guard AD, and we wanted to see Maxi guard him. No, we're going to know tomorrow if we're playing or not, tomorrow morning, I think. So we'll go home if we're not playing. There's no need to fly to San Francisco.
Well, I don't know how big a delay it would be. You guys don't play till Monday, and the Warriors don't play till Wednesday.
We wouldn't play the Warriors. The schedule, you would have to move on and figure out, reschedule that game somewhere in the schedule. You wouldn't wait for Golden State to play, because they still got to play Utah.
Oh, I see.
Yeah. So. All right.
Thanks.
It was a 4-point game at halftime. Why do you think it got away from you guys in the second half?
You know, some shots didn't fall. You know, there were some times where we came down the court and we just weren't moving the ball well. You know, we were just kind of getting up jumpers instead of trying to get into the offense and trying to move the ball around so we can get a better look.
How difficult is it trying to guard AD when he gets it going like that?
You know, he's a great player. You know, being able to know that there's someone that's effective on the ball and with the ball, and makes you just try to press up on him and try to make him get out of his game. But, you know, it's hard. You know, he starts to get it going, and whenever he gets some energy, it's hard to stop him. But he's a great player.
Derek, we know throughout the season you're obviously going to grow as a player, but how has your mental toughness grown so far this season?
It's really just got to be able to stay focused no matter what's going on the floor. You know, they're going to make their runs. We're going to make our runs. You know, there might be times where we're not making shots or we might be all out of whack, but we still got to be able to be poised. You know, we got to be able to have chemistry and try to move the ball ahead, try to push the ball. And, you know, there's some times where we can't come out on top, but we got to learn from these. We got to bounce back.
I know AD was physical, but it was like the rest of the Lakers were kind of pushing guys around. How did you feel about that for the rest of those guys?
You know, it was going to be a physical game coming in here. We all knew that. You know, there was going to be a lot of ups and downs and a lot of pushing, a lot of ticky-tack fouls being called, but at the same time, they let us play. So there was times where we try to bring up our defensive intensity. And, you know, I definitely think we should have kept it up the whole game, but I feel like we took our foot off the gas a little bit and they were able to get out over top.
What did you see from the double teams when you guys doubled AD in the post? How do you think you guys executed?
There was points and times where we executed well and points and times where we didn't. You know, we left the top of the key wide open many times. You know, usually we're more focused on Xing out the corners. And I feel like there was just a mistalking on the back line. But, you know, we got to be able to move past it. You know, we got to be able to fix our mistakes and get ready for the next one.
Did you sense that Kyrie wasn't the same when LeBron crashed into him
earlier? You know, I feel like that's you can't say he wasn't the same. You know, being able to get hit by someone that big, you know, even I would be hurting from that. I wouldn't say that caused the game they had. He just had an off night. You know, some shots didn't fall for him. We're going to give him the ball and get in the same positions the next game. And we know he's going to make the shot. So just because he missed it this game doesn't mean he's not going to do it for the next.
Has the coaching staff mentioned anything about the uncertainty of y'all's schedule? May not play Friday, or has there been any discussion about
it? You know, I have no clue. I've been focusing on today's game, haven't been focused on the next. So I'll have to get back to you on that. Appreciate you.
Early in the second quarter, you made a three-pointer and you just kind of went like this. Did you just kind of feel like it was that kind of a night?
I mean, yeah, you know, always for me, first game back is tough, you know, the legs. I thought a lot of threes that was going in, but it didn't, you know. So it's just that one that went in. It was a good feeling.
You guys were only down two at the half. What happened there in that third quarter when they outscored you by 15?
They couldn't miss a shot, you know. I think we play good defense, especially in the first half. And the third quarter, they were just knocking everything down, so that was tough to move on.
So who's the band that you got into it with right at halftime?
Well, I don't know who it is. It's okay. He was chirping the whole game. I'm good with it.
So the last three games, you saw, you know, big performances from Kyrie. How do you guys can kind of mesh that together to where you can look at your best and he can be his best at the same time?
We did it before, you know. Just some days one's going to have a good game, some days others are going to have good games. But when we play both at our best, you know, it's kind of tough to stop us. So hopefully we can get to that next game.
Luka, even if tonight is an example of a result you don't want, what do you think has been the key for the team to still be at the within the top of the West, even with all the different injuries throughout the season?
Yeah, I think it's our defense, you know. Our defense, I think we improved a lot since the start of the season. But our defense needs to start the tempo. We need to have an offense. So when we play good defense, we got a good pace, and we just start knocking down shots.
How difficult, in your case, you've been hurt and haven't practiced, but the team as a whole has not practiced 3.5 weeks. How difficult is it?
I mean, it's tough. I don't remember last time we had practice, honestly. We were playing every second day, so it's tough. But that's the NBA season, you know. You have 82 games. It's always a good tempo. So to come back, you know, you got to make sure on your own to get ready for the game, which is different tempo, so it's tough. Yep, thank you.